Suppose that we want to differentiate the function, the square root of the quantity x squared plus 1. We don't know how to do that using any of the derivative rules we know so far, but we notice that this function is composed of two functions that we do know how to take the derivative of, square root of something and x squared plus 1. We're going to call that square root the outside function, and x squared plus 1 the inside function. And if we compose these two functions, if we take x squared plus 1 and we plug it into the square root, we get back our original function. Now the question is, how do we take a derivative of two functions that are being composed? Well, we're going to look at our derivative as a slope again. We're going to think of it as a change in y over change in x. And we're going to notice that we can break this down into change in y over change in u times change in u over change in x for some other function u. So in our case, this inside function, this u, would be x squared plus 1. So we can say that u is a function of x, and we can think of f as a function of u. And then it's just square root of u. Now, that's helpful because what we want to find, dy dx, can then be thought of as the derivative of y in terms of u times the derivative of u in terms of x. Now, this is in no way a proof, but this is what the rule ends up being for the derivatives of compositions of functions. So how does it work? Well, if we're going to do this, we're going to need to know f prime of u, and we're going to need to know u prime of x. So let's calculate those. So we have our outside function, f of u equals u to the 1/2, and so we can say that f prime of u is 1/2 u to the negative 1/2. And then we have our inside function, which is u of x equals x squared plus 1. And then we can say u prime of x equals 2x. So how does that help us define capital F prime of x? Well, according to the chain rule, it's going to be the derivative of the outside function. So it's this right here, 1/2 u to the negative 1/2 times the derivative of the inside function. So that's our 2x. Now notice, though, that this looks very strange because our function is in terms of x. And here we have an x, but here we have u. Now we brought this u stuff into this problem. We don't want to have a u in our answer. We want it to say x squared plus 1 and not u. So really, we're going to have that f prime of x is 1/2 x squared plus 1 to the negative 1/2 times 2x. So notice that what we've done is we've said that to take the derivative of a composition, we're going to get two terms as our answer. We're going to get the derivative of the outside function, and then this is key, with the inside function plugged in unchanged. So that's the first term we're going to get. And then we're going to get that term multiplied by the derivative of inside function. So let's try this in another example. Say we want to find the derivative of y of x equals tangent of 12x squared minus 2. So what will that look like? Well, the outside function here is tangent of something, and the inside function is 12x squared minus 2. So when we take the derivative of tangent, we get secant squared of something. And when we take the derivative of 12x squared minus 2, we get 24x. So now if we follow the chain rule, y prime of x is supposed to be the derivative of the outside function. So that's this. With the inside function plugged in, unchanged, times the derivative of the inside function out here at the end. So that's how we apply the chain rule to take the derivative of a composition of functions.